never
All right,
forget.
Let's move on to save rounds and alibis. Kate, we'll start with you. What do you got?
I don't think I have anything. This is my first week back at work, and I have only come in 2 days out of four so far. It's harder than I thought it was going to be.
Why?
So shout out to just because there's no he's not on a schedule yet, so it's so hard to create a schedule
right.
based around because we thought we'd be able to like just pass them off to one another and get work done. But it's fucking hard.
You'll figure it out.
So yeah, let's we'll put you in the position of like somebody from Norway.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They get 2 years.
What?
Of the military gets 16 weeks or something like that.
Now a year.
6 months.
They're trying to do a year. The Marine Corps does a year.
What? Wow. That's awesome for the Marine Corps.
Yeah, I think it's implemented. If not, it was something that was the commandant's recommending.
Mm-hmm.
Like, did they actually do for a year?
Yeah.
2 years in Norway. I don't want to stay home for 2 years. It's 2 years for the mother and 1 year for the father.
Wow.
That's
yeah.
That seems excessive.
Like, how do you get adjusted back to work life?
Right. Like,
I understand, like, it is great, like, having family be, like, a priority.
Yes.
And that's one of the offsets of socialism there, the way that they do it, like, how much people are taxed. They have that ability to do that. But if you're in a job like this, Kate takes off for 2 years, we might as well just close up shop.
Yeah, there's
no. But any job, you go away for 2 years, they're not waiting for you to get back. They're not like halting that work. Somebody else is going to pick up and start doing that work.
Marketing has got to be completely different. Like, even if you work in marketing, the real estate market, anything, there is nothing that stays stagnant for 2 years.
No.
Yeah.
Even food, even if you're like a chef, like the way that you cook has got to be different 2 years from now.
Yeah. I think the military is probably the only space that I can think of off the top of my head where you could disappear and come back and like, okay, everything's pretty much the same.
What if you left in like 2005 and you're like, well, by the time I get back in 2 years, surely this war is going to be over.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, you got fucking 8 kids and it's still going on.
Yeah. I don't know. But no, it's been good to figure it out, but definitely still working on figuring that out and all that jazz. But other than that, it's nice. You brought me my favorite slice of pizza today, chaps. You dragged a booby milk fridge up to the second floor, so you're really crushing it. Thank you.
Cons, what about you?
So I tweeted about this. Tomorrow, as you're listening, Saturday, I'm going up to West Point. The gentleman behind Army Barstool for the last few years is graduating.
Delightful gentleman.
Yes, indeed. Yes. And that's big of you to say, because he made a lot of crayon jokes.
Yeah, and he called me out for many mistakes I've made online. Anyway.
Well, anyway, he asked me.
Fuck that guy.
Yeah, fuck that guy. I hate that guy.
That fucking boot.
Yeah, fucking boot. Yeah.
He asked me to commission him, so I get to go there and put his right hand, my right hand up, and I'm pretty sure I got it memorized now.
I wish he would do a commissioning joke where he's like, "Oh, you asked me a commission, and you just bring like a picture of him that you drew." You thought that he was commissioning
like,
you to
yeah.
for a drawing?
Yeah, that's good stuff.
No, I completely misunderstood what your request was.
Sorry about
here.
That. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to that. No, but it is a really big honor to get asked to do something like that, and it's a very important day for him. So not sure why he asked me, but I'm very honored that he did ask me. So that's pretty cool. And then...
probably because of COVID.
Probably. Yeah, there was nobody else, right. And I was close.
Yeah.
All right, that's probably why.
Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway... So before we were recording, I was I love pictures, so I love the app Time Hop and getting reminded of things. Yeah. And
I love just a huge generality. I love pictures. That's like when Kate was like, I'm getting back into music. I'm starting to, this music thing might really catch on.
Yeah. So, but.
You guys had food? Love that shit.
You guys heard of television?
Yeah.
I love entertainment.
Yeah. You guys like shows?
Yeah.
Entertainment.
You ever seen a person?
I love visuals. I love looking at stuff.
I'm big on rainbows.
Yeah.
But so one of the pictures today kind of like stopped me in my tracks. Usually I just like flash through it, and unless something's like real funny, I just kind of get through it for the day.
Yeah.
But today I was going through, and one of the pictures was a picture of my rearview mirror. 10 years ago today, I was leaving Fort Hood, leaving active duty.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Does that make you feel old as fuck? That you've been out
no,
for a decade?
No, because...
It should.
Dude, it doesn't feel like... Like these 10... I'm sure a lot of people could say this, but these last 10 years just kind of flew by. And when I think about all the stuff I've done, places I've been, people I've met, great experiences, I'm like really fortunate, but it doesn't feel like 10 years. So it was just really cool to kind of reflect on that.
I had the same when I was talking to somebody, not in the same military vein, but I was telling them, in 4 years, I will be a dad for half my life.
Yeah.
Whoa. Holy shit.
Time's weird.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I was reminiscing on it and some of the things I've done since then. I was kind of getting a little choked up thinking about it. It's wild, man. Think about both of you. Think about everything that's happened in your life in the last 10 years.
I got a divorce.
Yeah.
You got a divorce and a kid.
And a kid. What a treat.
Me, I'm officially 10 years. I'm like 15 years away from that, which is great. But I have McCartney.
Yeah.
There you go.